I don't begrudge the athletes doing whatever they want to do in their time off. You want to go drink on your day off? Go ahead. You want to go to a club? Go ahead. But when the playoffs are a week away, and it's the first time you've made the playoffs in a long time, and you're going to Green Bay, and you beat Washington, you get on the train with the team back to New Jersey, you get on a private jet, you fly down to South Beach, and you're at Live Nightclub with Justin Bieber and Johnny Manziel and Trey Songz, the singer-rapper. And the next morning, you're up on a boat, and you're out till 6 o'clock in the morning partying. It doesn't look good. Doesn't mean they can't do it. Doesn't mean they're not allowed to do it. It looks horrendous.
What even looks worse is that your man Odell Beckham Jr. there is wearing his he's wearing his Timberlands.
They're all
on
wearing
a boat.
Jeans, Timberlands, and no shirts.
Timberlands on a boat? Who does that?
Well, that's apparently that's
the
new thing.
I'm old school. All right, I'm old school. I get it. I don't know where these guys find the energy to do all this crap. Just trying to get through a season is hard enough.
You think Victor Cruz, because of what he's been through and where he's at, would not be that guy?
I have no idea what these guys are thinking about, man.
Now, here comes the bigger problem. In one of the pictures that's out there from the boat, Trey Songz has a joint in his hand.
Of course he does.
And
for mainstream America, nobody gives a crap. I mean, because everybody wants the stuff legal anyway. But for the NFL and for the New York Giants, I mean, I can't believe that these guys would do this to their coach. You know, the coach has got to get up there and he's got to answer questions about this crap. And I'm sure this crap goes on. But, I mean, I would just like to say, hey, Odell, man. Look, can you just hold off for a week until you get your ass kicked in Lambo, and then you can go out and party for the next 6 months if
you want? Do whatever you want.
I mean, do whatever you want.
Or maybe you beat the Green Bay Packers.
Well, you know what?
And you get to the next game.
And here's why. I mean, and these guys, I guess they just don't get it, man. I guess they just don't get the optics of it and how it's going to come off. And, yeah, it's their day off, and I'm a guy that says go get away from the game if you want and all that other stuff. And I wasn't a guy that could afford a private jet back in the day. I guess if I were playing today and I could afford it, maybe I would just go on and get on it and go get it, I guess, and go have a good time.
It's like Tony Romo and Witten and those guys in Cabo, right, before their playoff game. And
They had a bye week. Didn't they have a bye week?
That was during a bye week, but the optics of it stunk. They came back and lost. And listen, the New York Giants are on the road against Green Bay. They're an underdog in the game. By all accounts, winning the game would be not a miracle, but would not be expected by the majority of pundits in the NFL. But when you're Victor Cruz, you've come all the way back from injury and you're complaining about how many balls are thrown your way, right? When you're Odell Beckham and it's your first time in your career in the playoffs, when you're Roger Lewis and nobody ever heard of you before, when you're that group of guys. And all anyone is saying to you is, wait a week, wait a month, party as much as you want with every Snapchat, Instagram, and cell phone camera in your face, do it all. But do you have to do it 7 days before you're playing the Green Bay Packers in a playoff game?
I know
that's the problem.
I know whose fault it is.
Whose fault is it?
J.R. Smith.
J.R. Smith, he wasn't on the boat.
Well, J.R. Smith did stuff like this when he was here for the Knicks.
Yeah, but still, I want to be clear. I don't want to overstate what's going on.
Say is that,
if they're drinking in Jersey, what's the difference? Is what most people say. If you're going out to One Oak or Marquee or whatever you want to do in New York City, and there's pictures of the guys partying till 6 a.m, it wouldn't look good either. But when you're 1,000 miles away.
And you're hanging out with Justin Bieber.
And you're with Justin Bieber.
Johnny Manziel.
Right.
Hey, I would say to Roger Lewis, hey, how's Johnny Manziel doing? How's his career going?